Good morning. How are you?
Fine.
Good, good. Ready? Good. Khamza Hamida.
Very good.
Very good. Wind?
Wind is
1.6. Good.
I can help you because sometimes this operator, he cannot English, speak English very well.
I can speak Korean. Khamza Hamida.
That's good.
Thank you, gentlemen. Good job, huh?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Numan.
Welcome. In some plants, they will see my face. You are not able to cut this one. See your age. You are not special.
Yeah.
Only you are making drama.
What is very interesting there, you can see the wind measurement. Right there you can see the little impeller or fan turning, and that is measuring the wind. There's a limitation of 5 to 9 meters per second. Once we reach 9 meters per second, we cannot proceed with the lift. And if the lift is in progress, that becomes very risky, and the lift should be aborted and returned, lowered back to site. So the wind now was 1.6 meter when I visited the guy in the cab, and the most probably in the order of 2 meters per second. That's the wind blowing at the top of the boiler floor structure. You can see that soft sling with the weight, how it's blowing in the wind. The team safety discussion, and then praying, and then ready for the lift. Now that guy is operating a small business. He's an entrepreneur here on the site. In that black drum is some cold drink with an ice and sweets and cookies. Good businessman. Yeah, the business is good. Safety officers clearing the area before the lift starts. 9:50 and the picker and the wind has picked up. I saw the cab driver showing in the order of 5 meters per second wind. I will not be surprised if the lift will be aborted. Let me go and check with them. Right, and that's the lift starting. That is Newman, the first rigger, right there in front of the beam. And while we wait for the initial lift, let's look at the crane. The total counterweights now fitted to the crane is 380 ton of counterweights here at the back. So the total crane weight is in the order of 550 to 580 ton. And there's the girder lifting. As I said, 550 ton is the total weight of the crane, and the girder is 136 ton. And the important part here is 380 ton counterweight at the back. There's Newman now. He started climbing the steps to the top. 65 meters, and he will direct the load from the top with radio contact, two types of radios, while the lift is in progress. Okay, now it's nearly 10 o'clock and that's the wind meter right on top of the crane, and the wind is most probably blowing around 5 meters per second now.
So how you go? Can you see the reading?
No, I cannot see the reading. No, I cannot see the reading, but I'm guessing because it's a little bit stronger than 4. And I know that's not what you want to hear, Mr. Choi. Yeah, it was 4 meters. It was 4 meters a second. It's most probably around 4 or 5 meters a second. Yeah, the wind is blowing. The wind is also not constant. And the beam, the load is swinging a little bit. So far, it's still safe. There's Newman, the first rigger. He's right on the top. And I'm going to zoom back a little bit. He's walking on that steel beam, and I'm zooming back a little bit so you can see the wind blowing. Look at that soft sling hanging from that tower crane. Well, it's still constant. The wind is blowing with not a constant speed. And there's another guy walking on the beam, the same as yesterday. That is tough, guys. quarter past 10. This is now 15, 20, 25 minutes into the lift, and this is halfway. Yes, this is halfway. There you can see the splice. That's the splice plate of second and third tier, right there in the middle. That's the splice plate of all the bolts. That's halfway. So two tiers passed and another two tiers to the top. Right, 10:29. It's about 75% through with the lift, and that's the crane driver, the Korean crane driver, specialist in rigging and driving, especially these size of cranes. And I'm standing now on the other side of the boiler structure, just to give you an indication from the perspective and the size. I will now turn around, swing around 180 degrees so you can get an idea of all the activities. Very deep excavations, very, very deep, very critical for this project to have this excavations completed. And that's the next boiler, boiler number 3. Well, look at this car, look at this image. Okay, I know we're driving around on gravel roads, but that car hasn't been washed for weeks now. It's just some observation. Another 8 or 12 minutes, and then the lift should be clear of the structure and the crane will then start moving forward, or not moving, crawling. Newman, our rigger, right on top, next to the beam. What is now important, you can see the counterweights. The full weight is taken up by the smaller boom at the back, and that wheels is now lifted from the ground. So the crane is in all practical for all practical reasons now ready to crawl forward. Once that beam is lifted clear from the structure, then the crane will crawl to reach a 37 meter radius. All right, this is the team that has to stabilize that weight, that big girder. The wind is swinging it, and these guys is battling. That's it, ready to move forward. The crane is gonna crawl now forward. There she goes. Beautiful. Then 55. 1 hour since the lift started. As you can see, let's look at the girder. Crane is gonna crawl now forward. The girder is sliding in between those two columns, the BB column on the right hand side and the BC column on the left hand side. And I imagine once the crane is in position on the 37 meter radius position, then the crane will lift the girder to clear on the BC column. The BC column is the left hand side on the picture now, and then put it on top of the column. Beam is the girder is nearly inside the structure, and then another 8 meters to lift to get it onto the BC column. Right in the center of the picture is the girder, and there you can see how the crane is crawling forward and how the girder is getting pushed into the structure. Once in position, then the girder will be lifted another 7 or 8 meters, and then swing towards us to put it on top of the column. a bit of a challenge this morning, not for the crane as much, but for the people to keep the girder in a line and to keep it straight. And that's the last bit of crawling, and the crane should be very close to the 37 meter. That's it. Right, the crane is in position. The boom is on its correct position. Now it's a matter of lifting the girder, lift it above the column, which I will zoom back, the column right in the center of your picture. And once it's clearing that column, then the crane will swing left and align the girder for installation. Seventeen minutes past 11. 1.5 hour of since the lift started, and the girder is in position. And a great job. A little bit of wind today that was a bit of a challenge for the guys with the guide ropes to maintain stability and alignment of the girder. But that's it. Another job well done. And as we say in Afrikaans, gooi milies. And here's our favorite trailer, the SPMT, self-propelled motor trailer. Thanking you, Lord, for giving me song. That's it, that's the end of the girder lift boiler 4.